I hung out by the bar. There's like, it was like you could just have any drinks you want. So I'd go to the bar and get whiskey. And there was like a crowd there from like a group from Alabama, like real, real Southern boys. And one has a Trump shirt on. I'm there with my father-in-law at the bar. And he comes over and goes, "I hear you're from Hollywood." I go, "No, I'm not from Hollywood. I live in LA." But I, he goes, "Yeah, you Mr. Hollywood." I went, "Not Hollywood. No one would say I'm
Were you
Hollywood.
Wearing that?
No.
Gang, gang. Boom, boom. Back off my broccolini.
Get your life together.
It is.
Don't touch me, bro.
I'm not touching you, dude.
The greatest show on earth. That's annoying.
That mustache.
What's up, dog?
Is eager, huh? That thing looks eager.
Yeah, that thing's a little lightning ball up there.
Dude, you'd be good out in the wild, I feel like, with that.
It's me, Wario. Is that how he talks? It's me, Wario.
Mario says, it's me, Mario. Wario just kind of says his name.
It's me, Mario.
Wario.
Oh, that's right. He's more of like, me, Wario.
It's
He's
me, Wario.
What are some of the other ones make?
Are we going to guess some people's outfits? Because it's a little tough, I think, for the fans. So I'm Wario from Mario series. You'd be Tranny Annie.
I'll take it.
I'll take it. Yeah. Tranny Andy.
Chappelle looks homeless, basically.
Chappelle is an urban haunted house employee?
No.
What?
Corey Taylor from Slipknot.
Nah, fam.
Yeah, no, that's who I am.
You're the last guy in every haunted house.
No, the last guy.
You're a GoFundMe right character for Halloween 7. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I sing for Slipknot.
I'm not too familiar with the Slipknot. Are you a Slipknot guy?
Slipknot? No, it's like a, what is it, like an Eagle Scout kind of thing?
No, it's a band, metal band out of Des Moines, Iowa. Shout out to Des Moines, Iowa.
Your costume is crazy.
Yeah. Bro, yeah.
What's the
word? Dude, you look like, bro.
What's up, motherfuckers?
Nah, man.
Oh, no.
Go to Slipknot 99. That's
my It's Halloween every day for Slipknot.
You look like a custodian that's like, you know what? I'm tired of pushing this mop. I'm going to mate with it. Yeah. And then you're the son of that.
That's my metal band right there.
We get that part, man.
There's 9 of us.
Yeah, sure there is, dude. But what we want to say is that you look like a custodian that's like, you look like your origin story is a custodian mated with his mom.
No.
And had a child.
No.
And now you're just full face first on the floor.
The fans are called maggots.
Yeah. Oh.
Well.
Maggots. I said maggots with an M.
Do they come out there and be like, what's up, maggots?
Yeah.
I've like maggots, twice. Like make America great again?
Oh.
I bet there's some strong maggots crossover.
Like the bug.
Yeah.
Like the bug.
Bro, you're the last guy in a, you're the final frontier in a haunted house. So.
No,
yeah, you're
that's
the last,
not me.
With the fake chainsaw?
I'm right there.
Yeah, we understand, man. You keep pointing over there, but...
Shout out to Des Moines, Iowa.
You look like a haunted house mechanic.
Yeah. You look like a mop mechanic.
Shout out to Iowa.
You look like somebody fixes mops.
Yeah. You look like the final character in a Compton haunted house.
Yeah.
I'll take Compton. I'll take Compton.
You look like Brozer.
Who's that?
Like when you get to the end, you got to fight the last dragon.
Bowser, dog.
Bowser.
Yeah.
Bowser. Not
but you're Brozer.
Brozer.
But no, you're Brozer, dog.
Why am I Brozer?
For sure,
you're
man.
Different, man.
Y'all just mad because my costume is dope, man. Shout out to heavy metal music, man.
Shout out to heavy metal.
Yep.
Shout out to Custodians
Worldwide.
Shout out
to
Bro, damn. You're,
shout out to the late night cleaning crew.
No.
Yeah, your secret power is wind.
Listen
day.
To Surfacing. That's the national anthem. You guys are haters.
Bro, will you get back in the closet?
Bro, y'all, man, look at you.
What? Talking about Tranny Andy?
Yeah.
I'm good, man.
This shit is dope, dog. No, came with socks, too. You just seen the front cover of what your costume came in. I mean, this thing screamed pedophile. You should have seen
On the cover? Yeah. Screams.
Champion pedophile, dude.
Rookie. First team all pedophile.
Not no rookie like the rest of you guys, dude. I'm the freaking Jim McMahon of pedophiles, dog.
Hell yeah, dog.
I'll throw it right at your son.
Yeah.
Y'all better back up, though.
Damn. Okay. Trenny Handy got two this right? morning, dog. Dude,
whatever,
Trenny
bro.
Handy going hard.
Bro, you look like a fluffer for Thomas the Train, dog. Oh, damn. You look fucking. Yeah. Yes, we can. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Oh, man.
Damn.
Wait,
bro.
Who's Kat?
Huh?
Can you guess?
Guess.
Chin.
No.
What are you talking about, dude? Gold chain, black.
Yep.
Look at that. Look at her stance. Look at the fanny pack.
Joe Rogan?
The light denim jeans. Ooh, Rogan's good guess.
Good guess.
Because I see the fanny pack. Let me keep guessing.
Rogan wouldn't wear a black turtleneck, though.
That's true. Let me see. Chin?
No.
You want me to give you some hints?
Uh-uh.
He tussles with men.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yes, he does.
Oh, I know who it is.
Chin.
Also Chin. Oh, yeah.
Cool. These can all be
we're
Chin.
In the area.
Oh, wait. I know who it is. It's a, let me think. I don't know who it is.
It was a good try. Anyone else?
It's a man or woman?
It's a man.
Okay.
Very famous man.
Is the hair to scale too?
No, but it's curly like his.
Yeah. Oh, but his isn't as long.
In that, yeah. It's
same
not
skin
long.
Tone though, but not
very
Asian.
Similar skin tone.
Oh, I know who it is. Is it that guy who sings the lead singer of
Slipknot?
Creed?
No, dude. Okay.
Yo, would you drop Slipknot, huh?
No.
Bro, you look like Slopknot, dude. Okay. Bro, there's a freaking cleanup on aisle four, dog. Yeah.
Okay. Scariest thing about you is your keys in your pocket, man.
How you know what keys are in my pocket?
That's yeah, that janitorial, that's
exactly.
dog.
Yeah, dude.
What's Slipknot's number one song?
That you would know? Have you heard Wait and Bleed?
Yeah. No.
Have you heard Psychosocial? No. Have you heard Surfacing? Sick?
Uh-uh.
No? Yeah, yeah. Left Behind?
Uh-uh. No, dude. Nope.
Okay.
And don't name anymore,
I am hated. No, okay, I won't name anymore.
They all sound like freaking sad letters. They all sound like sad letters
to a bunch of lonely men. Mm-hmm. That's what it is.
Hey, I discovered them when I was a kid. 99.
You were a maggot since you were a kid?
Yeah, since 99.
Make America great again, dog.
Oh, there it is.
There it is.
There the Rock. Yeah.
It's pretty good, dude.
Dwayne Johnson.
That's why she keeps going like
that's
this.
That's why I keep going like this. When Brendan walked into the studio, I did the same thing. I was like, can
it's
you
so
guys?
Funny.
She's the pebble.
I'm the pebble.
She's the pebble.
Yeah. I like rocking it. The little pebble.
Yeah, I thought maybe something happened to you or something. Like something happened to your arms, you know?
Mm-hmm. That was
which
good
is
guess,
understandable.
Though.
And then, yeah, totally, then yeah. Nick is the green man from Always Sunny. Mm-hmm.
Green man on just a little bit of acid right now.
Green man.
Oh, you on acid?
Just a little bit, you know, keep okay. it interesting.
You got to do something.
You're on acid right now?
No, no.
Oh.
God, no.
Wow.
The producer of Adam Carolla's show, he was The Rock one time, and he tweeted at him, and the Rock saw it, and he replied, damn right, buddy.
Oh,
candy
right.
corn and condoms in that fanny pack.
Candy damn. Corn and condoms?
Yeah.
Wow. Wow. Chris, that's what The Rock said?
Yeah, and Chris Laxamana, wow. producer of Adam Carolla's show, responded, as of this morning, only candy corn.
Funny.
That's hilarious.
Dwayne coming in hot. Now, Chin decided not to dress up?
I dressed up.
This is lazy, Chin.
Can't tell.
This is lazy.
It was last minute, and I had to figure out something, so I made something.
Asian,
I never dress up like, I don't do
oh,
this.
You're a model.
No, not a model.
Really? Because the dude gave him a card? Yeah.
He's yeah. Chin in an alternate reality. He went the modeling route.
You want me to give you a hint?
I know what it is. Hold on. Let me guess, man. Don't give any
yeah,
hints,
dude. Yeah, give us a
dude.
Chance, dog.
What do you mean? You always like hints, dude. Don't lie.
I do like a hint.
Go for it.
I am.
Oh, okay.
It just takes some time.
All right.
Yeah. Are you Justin Bieber in Asian face?
That's very close.
Ooh.
Bruno Mars.
Oh, you're BTS. Oh,
nope.
Ooh, good.
BTK.
Not BTK.
BTK, okay.
B2K. Blind Torture Korean.
Not B2K.
Chris Brown.
No. Not even different ethnicity altogether.
You're Asian?
Yes.
Oh,
Asian.
I know who it is. Oh. Mario Lopez.
Yes? No.
Oh. No. What's the guy? She Bangs.
William
no.
Hung?
She bangs. She bangs.
I don't think William Hung dresses like this.
Oh.
This flashy.
What Asian
Bobby Lee.
Bam.
Oh.
Do you see it? I was going to give you that hint. I was like, when I was nine years old, dude. I was brutally molested by someone with Down syndrome.
Too much.
I was going to do that.
Wait. When I was young, I was molested by a retarded guy.
Look at Bobby.
No.
Look at him.
Is there a specific picture you?
When Bobby's never looked that good, dude.
It's like a, the
Bobby
viral
looks
clip.
Like something that got stuck in your vacuum.
Story. Or
okay.
What? You should. I should have let you borrow my yellow glasses.
I know. I was looking for glasses.
Bobby looks like Bobby looks like the last stuffed animal in a skill in an abandoned skill crane. There's no way.
Yo, that clip you posted of him, Nick, where the dude asked if he could be Mr. Miyagi.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, gosh. I was dying laughing. And he just stares at the camera for 10 seconds.
He's not wearing a beanie.
Well, the crazy part is that he looks exactly like Mr. Miyagi, and he just refuses to admit it.
Accept it. He looks identical.
Mr. Miyagi has gray hair, though.
Yeah. He's a younger Mr. Miyagi.
Dude.
Come on,
Christ,
bro. Use your imagination, dog.
Oh, okay.
God, dude.
I know how time works.
What's anybody doing for Halloween, man?
I don't know, man.
I think we're going to have trick-or-treaters for the first time this year. I mean, like,
I thought it was canceled.
Is that true?
What a bummer. Technically?
Well, no. Communities are still doing it, but they're like throwing the candy as you go by, me sounds fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a parade.
It's trunk-or-treat right now. I think everybody's doing trunk-or-treat apparently where they're going. Yeah, like people are parking their cars.
Yeah, and you go up to the car. It's a real bummer.
It's very, I mean, when I was young, you were that was like some guy in a car with candy was like the not thing.
Yeah. Mm. That wasn't the move.
Yeah, it was like that was the
it was frowned upon.
Sneaky man. Yeah.
Although you put a set of Cadbury eggs in that van, I'm going to go and jump in and take my chances.
Yeah.
Oh.
Brennan tried to raise a Cadbury egg.
I nurtured the Cadbury egg.
Bro, for like 2 months, dude. He's like, hush, little baby.
Sitting on it.
Yeah. And then he just ate it one night.
Yeah, eventually I just ate that bitch.
He was sleep eating one night, and he just ate it, you know?
Sleep eating?
Man, yeah, it's like sleepwalking, but it's just with your face.
Man, forget y'all. I'm having a Halloween party at the crib for the kids.
You are?
Yep, we got a bouncy castle. We got haunted shit coming up.
Hell yeah.
I think we rented a Dracula, which is always dicey, especially during COVID. Rented a Dracula. That means a grown man who thought he was going to come here and be fucking Vin Diesel didn't work out, so now he's doing these gigs.
Is it going to be the same guy who did the Spider-Man for you?
No. That guy is on the no-call list.
Damn.
That fat Spider-Man showed at my son's birthday party. It was not fun.
Magicians a lot of times will do... be pedophiles.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, really? Why is that?
Huh? Yeah, no, that's why is fact. That? Tell them.
Why?
Tell them.
Yeah. Well, first of all, it happens a lot. First of all, I don't want to say it, but it happens a lot in the Vietnamese community also.
Oh, wow.
And sometimes, because they do magic, they get people get up close by them. It's easy. There's an element of surprise. So you already can trick a kid. Like, oh, I got a, you know, an eagle in my truck or something.
Oh, that's a card in your pants.
Yeah, yeah. There's a bunny in your in my dad's basement.
Yeah, there's a bunny in my butt.
Yeah.
One of the kids goes lays eggs.
That's dark magic now. Yeah.
But a lot of times dark magicians magic. Will do also pedophile.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So will the balloon workers. That's also.
Oh, yeah. They seem the fucking... sus.
Oh, yeah. You ever seen a cool looking balloon maker?
No.
Never. It's science.
Look at twisting those long balloons. Balloon maker.
Like, suicide.
Or suicide and magician.
Yeah. Also, clowns aren't really a thing anymore, right? Like, it's been so documented where clowns are scary as shit that they've kind of evolved away from the clown. Like, that show, American Horror Story, like, you don't see clowns anymore, man.
What's scary anymore? I guess just like.
Ghost?
Terrorist?
Yeah. iPhone updates.
You really want to scare people. Show up as an ISIS member with a bomb on your back. Like a fake bomb. That'll scare the shit out of people.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Or that's screenshots of DMs.
Ooh. Receipts.
Receipts.
Damn, that's scary.
Larry Gray and Theodore Annaman are the two most notable magicians to have offed themselves.
Only two of them, huh?
Yep, Teddy and Larry, bro.
Magicians don't seem like they have a suicidal imagination, you know what I'm saying?
That is interesting.
You know, a lot of
I could have used a magician in Montana, man. I was fucking freezing, dude.
Were you? But you went there, though.
They didn't expect it. We didn't expect it. It was negative 14 at night, dude.
No.
You've been in negative 14?
Yeah.
You can't do much. It was freezing. Good time, though. Good time. It's cold. I hung out by the bar. It was like you could just have any drinks you want. So I'd go to the bar and get whiskey. And there was like a crowd there from like a group from Alabama, like real, real Southern boys. And one has a Trump shirt on. I'm there with my father-in-law at the bar. And he comes over and goes, "I hear you're from Hollywood." I go, "No, I'm not from Hollywood. I live in LA." But he goes, "Yeah, you Mr. Hollywood." I went, "Not Hollywood. No one would say I'm
Were you
Hollywood.
Wearing that?"
No. I thought about it. That would make sense if I was in character. Yeah. And he has a Trump shirt on. Mm-hmm. And he goes, "I bet you don't like my shirt." And I was like, "Excuse me?" He goes, "I bet you don't like my shirt." I'm like, "I don't care about your shirt. I don't care, man." He goes, "Yeah, you LA boys, you don't like Trump." Like, I think he was looking for a fight and he was drunk. He's like, "You LA boys, you don't like Trump." I'm like, "I don't like either of them, but I don't care about your shirt, man." And he gets in my face. I swear he gets in my face. My father-in-law goes a step between us. He goes, "You know your boy." He goes, "Your boy, Joseph Biden, gonna raise taxes on people like me." And I was like, "Okay." And I go, "People like you?" He goes, "Yeah, I'm rich." And walks away. I'm like, "What the fuck?"
The redneck guy said that?
Yeah. Damn. He goes, "I'm rich." Oh. Walked away. I'm like, "All right, dude.
Total wow. redneck
I
shit.
I know. Joseph Biden, he goes, "Your boy." "Your boy."
"Your boy."
"Your boy." I'm smelled like fucking vodka.
"I'm
Your boy." "Gonna raise taxes on people like me."
Bro, you fucking, you look like a guy that changes the spark plugs on a fucking gay cruise ship. You look fucking awesome. Thanks. You look awesome, bro. Bro, you look like Willy Wonka's hitman.
Shut the fuck up.
Yeah, dude. Definitely.
Oh my God.
Bro,
dude, you look like the last person. You look like the last person picked at an orgy. Who wants Trendy Andy? Come on, man, he showed up for this.
Come on, guys.
Come on, guys. He has a positive attitude. I know he looks rough around the edges. Well, you're looking at two dudes who could use some help. By help, I mean some better help.
Oh yeah, man, I've been getting help, but has it been better? Jury's out.
You think you dress like Wario and don't need better help?
I'm not.
I am, dude. Listen, there's something interfering with your happiness or it's preventing you from achieving your goals.
Mm-hmm.
How about you check out BetterHelp? They're going to match you with your own licensed professional therapist. You can start communicating in under 48 hours.
What if I need the help now, man? Can I get it now?
We got you, dog. We got you. The service is available also worldwide. Log on anytime. Send a message to your counselor. You get a timely and thoughtful response. Plus, you can schedule weekly video or phone sessions.
Mm-hmm.
So you're ready to go. BetterHelp is committed.
I need help.
I know you do, dude. And BetterHelp's the way to go. BetterHelp wants you to start living a happier life today, Theo.
I want to.
All right, man. Visit their website and read their testimonials that are posted daily, all right? Visit BetterHelp.com/KATS. That's BetterHelp, H-E-L-P. Join over the 1 million people taking charge of their mental health, all right, with experienced professionals. In fact, so many people have been using BetterHelp, they are recruiting additional counselors in all 50 states. Special offer for the King and the Sting listeners. Give it to him, dog. Give him the BetterHelp.
Special offer for King and the Sting listeners. Get 10% off your first month at BetterHelp.com/KATS. That's 10% off your first month at BetterHelp.com/KATS. Look, man, it's about that time, baby boy.
Holidays are coming up, dog. You want to give that diamond thing to your thing?
You need that diamond for that dime, you feel
Ooh.
Me? And if you're in love with a man or in love with a woman.
Yeah, maybe your man wants a diamond ring.
Maybe you want to slap something on your buddy's wrist, tell him y'all been in a work truck for years and it's about time to say, "Hey, buddy, you know what I'm saying? I've been thinking about you, God. Your time for love is now, and there's only one way to tell somebody you love them, and that's with a piece of blue Nile fine jewelry. It's a special occasion, is it? Well, take care of it.
Take care
From
of it,
From engagement to anniversaries
God.
And birthdays, you need a trusted, no pressure online jeweler to help you celebrate. People are getting their damn teeth fixed through the mail. hell yeah, you can get a piece of jewelry.
Hell yeah, BlueBlue.com, you're in control.
If he's unique, if he's one of a kind, and if his taste in jewelry is something secretive, but and they need something spectacular in particular.
Yeah, get him.
Get him done.
Yeah, get it done. Get her done. Never settle at BlueNile.com. Choose from more than 100,000 ethically sourced Gia grade diamonds in every shape and size, with endless selections of settings to help you design.
Never settle. You can create your perfect size ring and they craft it. Blue Nile has a simple online tool that lets you choose the diamond, shape, size, and clarity, as well as style. Blue Nile's bench jewelers will then build your perfect ring. Each one is one of a kind.
They are. They're fantastic, all right? And let's give them a deal, dog. Give them the deal. 100% satisfaction guaranteed. BlueNile.com and King of the Sting listeners get $50 off your first purchase over $500. Use code KINGSTING.
Yep.
That's code KINGSTING.
KINGSTING when you go to BlueNile.com. Get $50 off your first purchase over $500. Now, here's the thing. If you have somebody you love, you don't know what to get them, but you know you want to spend $500 or more, then this is it. There's no... What are you going to do? You're going to drive over there to the Old Navy or something? You ain't going to do all of that shit.
Nah, man.
Go to BlueNile.com. Use code KINGSTING.
Plus, every order is insured, ships free, and arrives in a discreet little package that won't give away the prize inside. Shop stress-free and find your forever peace. Go to BlueNile.com today.
Get that item, baby.
Oh, how'd your softball game go, dude?
Right now, we are 1-2.
Ooh, bad team. What do you think the problem is? No chemistry?
No, we didn't have enough players. Somebody got sick on our team. One of the restaurants where some of the players work got sick. Mm-hmm. Like half the staff got sick.
So you played with only half the team?
It was like a faux yum or something. What's it called? Faux yum. So yeah, they had a faux yum. Something happened.
You're missing some important people?
We missed two people. We only have, I think, 8.
Ooh.
So we're already... You only field 7.
Mm-hmm. So you guys are still good, though?
Not good.
Who beat your ass?
1-2. This seafood outfit, Clark's.
Clark's like put it on you?
Yeah.
Do they have a 20 run rule? Or if you get down by 20, we just call the game? Like, if it's the third inning.
Yeah, we haven't 20. Had. I haven't had any of that experience.
Oh, not a lot of points. Are they close games?
Let me see. One of them, no. One of them was, I think, 13-2.
That's an ass whooping.
One of them we won probably maybe 13-10.
Close game.
And then the last one we lost. And somebody, there was like a car accident right by the field too. So it was hard to, there was like.
You guys were distracted.
Yeah. There was fire truck.
And how are you doing personally? Ambulance. Are you MVP?
No.
Those little Asians striking you out, huh?
Yeah. I'm more like DM, whatever the, yeah.
DMV?
DMV, yeah.
DMV. Yeah, you're striking out.
Yeah. Trying my best, but there's a lot of diversity going on. Mm-hmm. You know? So, but it's good, man. They got a lot of people out there. You know, you meet a lot of people. Who else did we lose to?
You mean any cool people? You make any new friends?
We lost to Wholesale Seafood. That's what we lost to. Clark's Wholesale Seafood.
Yeah, Clark seems to be pretty buttoned up.
And then there's another group that we lost to that was a it was a local bar, like just a bar someplace.
Like Shotgun Willie's?
Paddy's or something, some Irish bar. Mm. You know, Snarker.
And how's the team's morale? You guys still pretty upbeat when you
try to ask Paddy's? No. There's Asian people. You have no idea what their morale is.
Yeah, they never change. You know? There's no baggage.
They could be literally going to their own funeral or going to their wedding. Have no idea.
No clue. Yeah. No clue.
Going and that's to not war all going Asian to, people. Yeah. I know the more tropical it gets, you get more smiles and kind of high fives. You know?
The closer to the equator, the happier people tend to be.
Yeah.
Outwardly.
You never know what's going on with Chin, man. Wow. Bad day, good day. He's good.
Oh, he's a mystery box.
Yeah.
He's a mystery box. You've got to really peel back his eyelids to know what's going on. You're like,
I just
here we go. Good day.
What's going on?
Oh, why sad, dude?
I literally just caught what Theo said.
And I don't mean that in an offensive way or anything.
Oh, sure.
My teammates are Asian, man.
I got heavy brows myself.
Yeah. And we all bow at the beginning of the game, which is kind of a cool team thing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Better than handshakes these days, so, I guess.
What, did you go trick-or-treating when you guys were kids, Kat, Culture Corner?
I used to go trick-or-treating a lot, but I didn't always dress up. I feel like I used to just kind of walk around with my younger cousins. And since I took them, they're obligated to give me candy.
Even when you were a kid?
When I was a kid, the only thing I remember dressing up as was the devil one year. Wow. And I don't remember anything.
This got
else.
Dark. Really? Okay. Just the really? Devil?
This got darker than Chappelle, dude.
I know, right? That's dark. You know what I mean?
Damn, Kat. Just the devil and then one and done, huh?
I feel like I don't remember many Halloweens. That's I don't know what it is.
Holiday, yeah.
I loved Halloween, but I don't remember anything from that. Mm.
Chappelle?
Hell no.
You didn't dress
last
up?
Last time I dressed up was elementary school.
Really?
Yeah.
Chappelle probably wanted it. I had you know, kind of darker friends a little bit when I was young who wanted to be, sometimes they would want to wear like dark clothes on Halloween and you'd have to be like, nah, man. It's dangerous.
It's dangerous.
Yeah, you can't wait. They're like, I'm going to wear a black shirt and pants. And be like, dude, you're going to get hit by a car. You need to be like a UFO, something with some lights on.
Some light. Yeah. Bright light. A lot of bright lights.
Yeah, something.
Yeah, I did not. That's not me.
There we go. No, that's me Theo. On the bottom left.
That's Theo. Oh, that's Theo. I was like, what the hell? I was like, why you pulled them up?
They used to call me Sugar Arms, baby. That's Don Gladys on the top right, 38 years old.
He looks like it.
Holy shit. What grade is that?
But in junior high, I was in ninth grade.
Get the fuck. That dude's supposed to be a freshman? Oh, yeah. The number 14 looks identical to LeBron James.
Oh, number 14 was like 6'9", bro.
Damn, are you guys good?
We had some behavior issues.
That makes sense.
I bet you guys beat the shit out of your fucking softball team right now.
Yeah, we didn't have we beat those kids, you know. Our team is bad.
So no Halloween growing up, Chappelle.
Hell no. Not important, dude.
What are you talking about, Chappelle?
I think the last time I dressed up, it literally was elementary school. I was one of them damn blue things.
Blue Man Group?
No.
Oh, a Smurf.
Avatar?
Smurf. Yeah, I was a Smurf. That was the last time I dressed up.
Fun. So you went in blue face?
Yeah, I went in blue face. Well, yeah.
Nick, what about you? Wisconsin?
Yeah, it was more chill.
Wisconsin. Oh, yeah. Halloween was our shit, like you. Yeah. Like,
right?
Somebody
freezes to death every year at a party. Literally, in the morning, like, oh.
And did you use, for your case, a pillowcase to carry the candy?
What a coincidence. That's actually the...
Like
the
goddamn gentleman?
That's actually our first submission.
Oh, here we go right here. This
Mr.
young model.
Blue Eyes. Huh?
Yo, yo, yo. Brandon Schlobs and Theo Thongs. What's up, man? My name's from Georgia. Got a little Halloween debate club for you gentlemen. When you all were younger, going trick-or-treating, getting them sweet hitters with your boys, did you keep the pillowcase or that bullshit-ass little bucket that your boys had to go home and dump it and come back? Let me know what
bullshit.
You guys think.
You took that
I love
bucket,
everything
fatty.
That y'all do.
Hell no.
Gang, gang, buzz, buzz, spooky season.
Spooky season, son. Wow. Dude, Mr. Steal your eyes.
That dude's trying to haunt your crotch, Kat. Yeah. I bet that dude.
I bet you show him your feet. Oh, that guy got some peepers on him.
He's got eyeliner.
Huh?
I feel like this man has eyeliner.
Bro, quit looking at his eyes that much, dog. You're
in love like much, man?
You got eyeliner?
Damn, bro.
Yeah.
You seem green or gay, dog.
Yeah. Is that a banana in your suit? Oh my God. Does that suit come with a cucumber in the front, huh?
You're like, does this guy dye his tongue? It's like, who knows if he dies?
God, that guy's skin's made out of porcelain, am I right, fellas? No, I don't know.
Is this guy wearing a filter? Is this Rio de Janeiro? What is going on?
It's Jakarta.
Look, man. Damn, dude.
Jakarta ready, Nick, over there, dog.
Chappelle looks like the lead singer of Parliament Funkadelic right now, dude. Can you bring up
George?
George
Clinton? Clinton.
Oh,
like,
oh, yeah, he does.
Atomic. No. Hey, come on now. I'll
Hotel,
take that.
Hotel, motel, Holiday Inn. Hey. Was that George Clinton?
No.
That figures.
But I know that song.
Damn, bro.
Oh my God. Yeah, I'll take that.
You look like George Clinton if we opened up his fucking casket right now. Oh,
that's a fair one. Bro, you look like Dedrick Douglas.
Why can't I just be Corey Taylor from Slipknot?
Oh my God.
Nah, it's too weak, man.
Yeah, they don't have that.
All right, I'm respecting.
You got to be a UFO.
Yeah, man. Yeah, I'm walking out outside with this.
You like, grave Clinton, bro.
Grave Clinton. Yeah.
Damn, bro. George Clinton is a legend. He's from Virginia. Wow.
Makes me dance.
He's a legend, bro. Oh, he was North Carolina, Kannapolis.
What were you saying about that gentleman, Nick, before you fell in love?
Well, personally, we used the pillowcase because there was Halloween, but then there was the weekend before Halloween where we went to nursing homes, and they were all like, there was like three of them in a row, and you just went up and down the hallways. It was way more efficient. You'd fill up an entire pillowcase.
And them old timers get full candy bars now. Mm-hmm.
And you can go around twice. Some don't even know.
Really? Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Damn. Wow.
Yeah, dope. Pillowcase all day. Yeah. That little fucking mop bucket. Get the hell out of here, man. I'd fill that pillowcase up. I'd kill them bitches.
We had that mop bucket sometimes.
Really?
Yeah, dude. The problem with the mop bucket, if that handle broke, and then you had to carry the bucket just with your arms.
Yeah, like a kettlebell.
Yeah. That thing was heavy, man. What else do we have? Oh, we got that the old school one with just the whatever this was when you were like a little kid. It was a pumpkin, you know?
Mm-hmm. Like, dude, a little tiny one.
Some kid at our school got his head stuck in a pumpkin. Oof. And yeah, he was in the little parking area at the school, and somebody slammed the fucking pumpkin. It was like a series of events into a fucking closed a car door on it, and it like saved him because the pumpkin was on his head.
Jesus. Shit.
But he put his head fully into a pumpkin real tight.
I'll tell you
what. Yeah, that's what we had right there.
That shit's weak. I'll tell you what's up.
Just hanging on he said that's what we had, bro. That's
not
all
like
we had.
Pillowcases, dog, because you fill that bitch up to the brim and they don't break.
They cared about their pillow.
Brendan would hook a handle onto his cheeks and just open his mouth.
Yeah. Insert. Insert only, dog.
Yeah. So what's this beautiful man want to know? Pillowcase? I don't know if we did pillowcase.
I don't know anyone that did anything else, because you could fit so much more candy in there. And then them dumbasses who would leave a giant thing of candy out with a sign because they're lazy that say, take one. Bitch, I'm seven.
Don't speak. Yeah.
I'm seven.
Yeah.
I'm taking all your candy.
I'm taking one for the team, bro.
Yeah, by team, I mean ear, buddy.
Yeah. And then you break their window, too. Well, yell the N-word in there.
Oh, wow. Damn. Oh, okay. That's that New Orleans Halloween. All right.
Yeah, man. More trick. More tricking, you know.
I remember some dumb bitch at the end of my street would give us pennies.
Oh yeah, throw them bitches.
You trying back. To get the shit on your doorstep? Pennies?
Wait, did you used to do the trick or treating for UNICEF? That's what that was for.
Dude, she would just have a thing of change and be like, "Oh, here you go." Or they'd give you full like apples. Mm-hmm. Ah, come on, man.
Did y'all ever egg houses or anything like that?
Not for
in
Halloween.
High school, we did.
No, you didn't. That was like
not
a
for
Halloween.
Halloween. You would do it just for as fun. We did it as fun, but not for Halloween.
I don't remember.
What kind of asshole does that on a holiday?
You get the apple, you give him an egg. It's tit for tat.
I think, I remember one year we got up on the roof and this fella named Pug. We had a fella in our neighborhood named Pug, you know, named after the animal. Because he was real.
Sounds like a handsome fella.
He had like a very.
Flat face?
He had that plateau face, they call it.
What? Had that snout.
Huh?
Had that pushback snout.
He was a little bit,
Was he Asian? Really,
you and him could have met in the middle, you think?
Oh, yeah. We could have. If we had a child, it would have a perfect nose. So he had an innie, you know, when it came to noses. Yeah. And we'd get on the roof and shoot pellet guns at him. We'd invite him over on Halloween. And he'd come across the street and we'd just lay into him.
Poor Pug.
Pop man. Off six or eight into him. Bro, he had skin that was perfect for taking pellets, though.
Oh, okay.
Some people it burns. It leaves up. He had that
thick skin.
Oh, he had that Cajun skin on him, man.
Yeah, hell yeah. You know?
Then it's fun.
Doc, how about I ask my mom? I said, because Nick asked us, hey, can you get that the French robot costume again for the show? I was like, oh, let me hit up my mom. So I text my mom and say, hey, mama, can you make me that French robot costume? She said, no. Just straight up, no. I was like, okay.
Not even a negotiation.
Haven't talked to her since.
Well, dude, she'd have to get a lot of fabric. You know what I'm saying, bro?
You could do it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Chin, man. You would Halloween big around your neighborhood in San Antonio?
In Texas, I can't remember too much of Halloween. I remember doing stuff, walking around the neighborhood and stuff, but I don't remember.
Why is everybody? Do you mean? Why does everybody have CTE in this motherfucker?
Walking around the neighborhood? Were you a fucking hitchhiker, dude? You remember Halloween?
I barely.
There's
remember.
Brendan right Look there, dude.
Dog, and there me and Jay as a fucking one's a tiger, one's a fucking ninja.
Oh, bro, you look like your son right adorable. There.
Yeah,
damn. Yeah, you really do.
He's my twin. There's Tiger's Buzz Lightyear last year,
and that's the same costume that fit me last year.
You guys do look a lot alike. That's crazy.
Tiger's insane though, man. Tiger's on what? He's on uppers or something.
Yeah, he's on something besides juice boxes. I'll tell you that right now. That boy, that Nowitzki needs to test that young
he's
man.
On test 700 or something, man. I've been over there to play with him. It is, man, he'll burn you out.
Dog, I'll tell you, he'll, in Montana, because we were trapped in the house because it's negative 9,000 degrees, but we went horseback riding. My horse's name was Fridge. Kind of hurt my feelings because they lined up the horses. I up my girl's normal horse, my son's smaller horse, and then here comes big old hefty Fridge just blow God out the side. I'm like, what the fuck? Like, that's your
drinking
horse.
A beer.
Drinking.
Who's riding me today?
Brushing his hair.
Dude, drinking gravy. This thing was fat. Yeah. Like, that's yours. His name's Fridge. I was like, man, that hurts my feelings.
Did you touch his nose?
Oh, man. I was all up on his nose.
Really?
Why did he like touch nose?
He loves horse noses. I don't know why.
It's all I care about on horses.
Can you see a video of someone touching a horse's nose? Mm-hmm.
Dude, but how about this? We get done riding the horse. We're all hanging about, talking about our ride and stuff like that. Fridge, big old black peepee comes flying out.
That log, huh? Dude, see, and what's sad is that makes your wife. This. Then you got to do something with the wife later.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's what I was all up on Fridge's nose.
Oh, that'll
like that.
Get you hard as hell.
Hell yeah, dog.
They like that?
Oh, I like it. I don't know if he does. For real, that horse's peepee was about this big, dog.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Oh, Mr. Hands, this thing was big.
Don't oh, they used up. To have it Mardi Gras when a horse would get erect. People throw nickels at their dick.
And you can't miss, son. That thing is
yeah,
thick
bro. Dude,
and
you
ashy.
Could have no arms and throw a nickel and you hit the horse's dick, bro.
Damn.
Kind of ruined the evening, though. Like, I found it funny, but nobody else did.
Oh, but here's the problem.
I said Fridge just gonna get his big dick out like that for us in negative 14 degrees.
The kid's over there petting his dick. You know? He's like blind birdie, whatever that thing is.
Pretty bird. Pretty
hey,
bird.
Petey. Hey Petey.
Don't pet it too much. That thing will spit at you now.
Brandon.
Too much.
That's your kid. No, if it was someone else's kid, man.
Well, there's
like,
other kids there, dog. That's not my kid. That's why I said it's someone else's kid.
Damn, bro, I ain't doing no pedophiling.
Yeah, you look like you would.
Yeah, but that's all right, dog. Yeah. You feel me, man?
Your costume begs the difference, son.
Bro, I look like a Navy SEAL at a fucking at a bathhouse. I look like a West Hollywood Navy SEAL, bro. Okay.
SEAL Team 6's side piece. Yeah. Look at you, dog.
SEAL Team 69, daddy. You feel me, huh? Who wants to pet Petey? Yeah. Dude, I'll tell you this, man. A
Pete
lot
wants
of
a cracker.
You know they have gay horses too. You bring it up, Nick.
Yeah, bring that shit up, Nick.
And it's becoming more popular than
wait,
it was.
Wait, they really do?
Yep.
Do they have a lot of horses in Vietnam, Kat?
They have water buffaloes more. Yeah.
The story about gay horses is honestly heartbreaking. Will you take us there, Nick?
So it said this may be one of the most heartbreaking love stories since Romeo and Juliet. What is it? Two gays. Here we go. Do not disturb our dinner.
Simonzi and Triola.
Features a story about two male horses, Simonzi and Triola. The strange bond they develop.
Mm-hmm. That's called homosexuality.
Two horses. Scroll them. What is it?
They call it a strange bond. You know that? Mm-hmm.
Nowadays, they just call it a bond.
Yeah.
You can't
bond.
Call it strange.
Strange bond.
Friends. How we know they gay?
Are they making love?
00 sucking, bro. Bond. Strange bond. You feel me? How many times do I have to say this joke?
I heard you the first time, man.
Well, hold on. You'll hear it in a second, so we'll hear it again.
I don't get it. How we know these horses
and that
are gay?
Now look at that horse over
ooh,
there.
Ooh, that horse.
Bro.
Hey. Yeah.
Bring that.
Check out that pony, dog. The one with the fresh hit. Mullet. No.
Come on, Nick. Jesus
come on, Nick.
Christ.
You missed the pony, dog.
Click on the fuck any of the right ones. There's 9 right ones. There you go.
Hey.
His name is Yahoo Login, dude. That is
that looks like your trainer.
Yeah,
oh, that looks like my trainer.
Dang, bro. Look at that bitch is fine. Zoom in. What are you
yeah,
fucking
let us see
doing,
you. Not,
dude.
Don't be scared. Look at this fucking dog. Huh?
Brenda said, don't be scared.
It looks just like Barbara Streisand.
Yeah. His nose looks like some nuts, though, dog. They look soft.
And zoom in on that butt, dude. Barbara's thighs can, ooh, dude. That thing is fine,
huh? Oh, yeah. That's a thoroughbred, dog.
Bro, I'll milk that thing, dog.
Meg the Stallion.
You feel
yeah,
me?
That's that little thought I was talking about.
Dude,
look
I'll
at that
shoot
thing.
I'll shoot that bitch in the foot. You feel me?
Yeah.
Yep.
I see what you did there.
Hell yep. Yeah.
Chappelle, dude. You scaring me, dog.
Why am I scaring you? I ain't even
your
do nothing.
Your costume scary, Chappelle, dude.
But y'all mad. Y'all mad. Your costume scary. Ooh.
that's an Ariana Grande horse. I'll ride that thing all night long, daddy.
Ariana Grande, bro. I'm in, huh?
Damn, that thing is fun.
Shorty wildin', huh?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Damn, that bitch is from Atlanta. Ooh. Okay, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Tory Lanez will shoot that thing in the foot. That thing fine, bro.
Both feet, dog.
Pull up another one, Nick.
Damn.
We get that brown one, go up too. Oh, get that cat.
Ooh.
Ooh. Dang.
Damn,
boy.
Look at the. Oh.
Oh, that's a little dog. Oh, now we're in the snacks again. That's the problem with Pinterest, dude. It starts off with whatever, and it always ends with muffins. Yeah. The further you scroll down, you just get to cookies.
Oh, dog, I saw a fucking moose. Damn. That thing is fine. I saw a moose in Montana. Mm-hmm. Dog, you ever seen a moose in person?
Oh, them bitches so big. Are
big.
I don't know if I have.
Big.
Could you touch 10 it?
10 foot tall. Oh, no way. Can't get near them. Aggressive as fuck.
You could have gotten near him, dude. How much do they weigh, you think? I don't
think so, 1,000 pounds? 10 foot tall?
Bryce Mitchell will put that thing in a fucking twister. Mm-hmm. He killed a deer with his nuts, dude.
Oh, damn, look how big nuts? That thing is.
Oh, Chappelle in person. That, I mean,
oh, that thing will beat a Honda.
My son
Civic.
Was like, "Oh, is that a dinosaur?" I went, "Don't be." I said, "Don't be stupid, man. Don't be fucking stupid."
He also probably looked at some of your old schoolwork, which is where he got that. where he got those facts from.
Look how big they are, man.
Damn, look at that's you, though, dog. Yeah.
Damn.
Just standing there, no clothes on. Only two fingers on each hand. What are you doing?
Is that an alien in the middle? What man looks like that?
It's a Lego person.
But now, be honest with me. Be honest with me, people in here, because do you think, if you see, obviously, a horse is... People make love to certain animals in certain areas, you know?
And some people let the animals make love to them.
Yep.
You ever seen Mr. Hand?
I haven't seen it.
You've never seen Mr. Hand?
Oh, no, you don't want to see it. You don't want to see it.
Bro, I'm Baptist. I'm part Presbyterian.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, sure. Leave him alone with that thing.
It's probably, thank you. It's probably illegal. I got your back. It's probably illegal.
Gang, baby. Yeah. We're fucking out here. Don't make you. I was sending my dog in to mop you up.
Yeah, yeah, dog.
You know what I'm saying, bro?
Yeah, I got the mop.
A bucket and a mop?
Yeah, I got the mop.
You got the fucking mop, baby. Slip mop.
Yeah, slip mop. Dude, I'll get that mop fucking.
Slip mop.
Slip mop, bro.
Yeah, dog.
Yeah, I got Theo's back.
I got your front, daddy.
Yeah, hell yeah. Gang. See that gang.
Damn, front, you back. You fucking out of here, French. Y'all gay. Hell yeah.
You French, bro.
Yeah. No, you look like a little maggot.
Your mom put you in a little French suit, bro. All right, man. What I want to tell you guys about is getting high, baby. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, you talking about that? High on liquid IV, daddy.
No, I'm talking about getting hydrated.
Bro. Oh, sorry.
Jesus
flu
Christ.
Flu season right
anybody
around the corner,
dog. Figured that out.
Anybody?
Listen. Flu season is right around the corner, and one way to stay away from COVID is to stay hydrated, man.
Yeah, dog.
One of the main things you got to do is stay hydrated. If you unhydrated, you might fall down somewhere. Somebody runs by, sneeze in your mouth. Damn, you got COVID, boy.
Yep.
When you're pushing your body hard or you're feeling run down, it's important to take care of yourself with the proper vitamins and nutrients.
Maybe you're pushing hard in your man or your girl.
Yep.
Dehydrated, dog. You want to hydrate up? Use liquid IV.
If you've been masturbating your body off like I do sometimes, you might want to change up.
You got to replenish that bad boy.
You got to refill that bus tank, man. And what I'm telling you is this. The same words of the famous Dustin the Diamond Poirier. Stay hydrated, baby. They have vitamin C, vitamin D. They have zinc.
Oh.
They have trace minerals.
Dude, each pack is bursting with fresh, natural tangerine flavor.
Oh, you
so
can
it
feel
tastes.
It. Feels like oof. It hits you in the back. Right when you swallow it, it feels like it lands on your back, man.
Yeah, like
with
a big old tangerine.
With every purchase, Liquid IV donates a serving of Liquid IV to someone in need.
Hell yeah. The company has donated over 5 million servings globally. I don't even know, but it sounds good. Liquid IV's new hydration multiplier plus immune support is available at Walmart or order online, get 25% off and be a lot safer just ordering at home, not going to Walmart. When you go to liquidiv.com, use the code KATS at checkout. That's 25% off anything you order when you use the code CATS at liquidiv.com.
Get better hydration today at liquidiv.com. Promo code Cats.
Cats. Dog, I look at you and I say, that man needs more meat in his mouth.
Oh, yeah.
But not just any kind of meat. You need real proper meat. You feel me?
Oh, I want that front loin, baby. You feel me?
Yeah, you want that foot long.
Oh, I want that squirt strip, baby. This Thanksgiving, Butcher Box is giving you something extra to be grateful for.
Dude, and Thanksgiving's coming up, man. Butcher Box is giving you guys something to do. Every month, Butcher Box ships a curated selection of high-quality meats right to your crib. All the meat is free of antibodies and added hormones.
I'm blind.
I like a little roids in my meat. You feel me?
I'm blind.
Why are you blind, dog?
Because I haven't been eating enough meat, baby. It's the best meat. Shipped right to your door. Cures blindness.
Oh, wow, dog. Okay.
100% grass-fed finished beef. Sometimes you get unfinished beef.
How about them free-range organic chicken?
Sometimes you got a burger, got a damn antler hanging out of it.
Hell yeah, that wild-caught Alaskan salmon. Not them bitch salmon that be caught up all the time. This is free, wild salmon.
Yeah, not them little water thoughts. This is nitrate-free bacon. It's the way that meat should be.
Dude, how about ButcherBox? You get the highest quality meat around $6 a meal. Also, even have free shipping nationwide, except Alaska, Hawaii. You got to pay for that. And right now, ButcherBox is offering new members a turkey for free. Gobble, gobble.
That's an entire turkey for free in your first box. Go to butcherbox.com/cats. That's butcherbox.com/cats. Take care of Thanksgiving. Take care of the holidays. Get it done now.
Gobble, gobble.
Get that free bird, fam.
It's all this candy, dog.
That was kind of the main event for this evening, candy draft. We go up a 3-round candy draft. I randomized the order up at the top of the board to make our picks. Theo would be first and select a candy and put it on the board.
Damn. If I don't get them good and plenty, I'm about to piss on y'all, dog.
Y'all got any Boston baked beans?
Someone in the first three picks take those good and plenty. You can't be giving away your picks like that. It's a draft. Yeah. We're in the war room right now.
Oh, I don't know how. I don't know how it works.
Like an NFL draft. Oh, Theo's going to be first pick. He'll go up. Out of all those candies, he gets to pick what's available.
Go up now?
Yeah.
I get the fourth pick in the first round?
It was a randomized draft order before the show.
Randomized draft, dude. It's just like Vietnam. I don't know if
I believe that. You're about fourth. I got fifth.
Bro, it's just like Vietnam.
You know damn well if you made Theo fourth pick in the first round, he'd hit chat for the show. We come back tomorrow, Nick has a black eye.
I fell. I should have
put him
door.
First. I should have put him first.
I like Nick that. Yeah, I fell.
I was third until we found out that Nick had another podcast network working here all weekend. So, Nick's like, no, I don't know what you're talking about.
Logos all over the screen. Hey, you guys mind doing a quick read for me real quick?
Oh, look at that gang, homie.
Dang, yeah, hell yeah. Y'all yeah, gang, hell yeah.
Halloween.
Yeah, bro. Slip Mop.
Dwayne, baby. I'm going hard in the fucking damn, paint,
that caboose still out the back, dog. Talking about that horse. Saddle up, partner.
I put them brachets, number one, baby.
If you want to add a thumbtack, because it'll probably come back.
I got them brachets candy corn.
Hey, so we pick and then we eat them?
At the end, yeah. You get your draft.
That's how you make it. Wait.
It's me, Wario. Come on, baby. Come on, dog.
Cat, you're up. We'll see the teams at the end. Each person will have three items.
God, how about Chin's picture?
I know.
Well, how about my picture? Look at them glasses.
We took that last week, dog.
I know.
The Chin's is from...
I shouldn't have been masturbating yesterday either.
Yeah. I respect it.
Nothing to do with candy, but...
You're up, Chin. What you jacking off in candy? What are they going
to
do?
I was jacking off. What do you want me to do, man? I was jacking off.
Both sins?
Huh?
Both sins for you?
I couldn't handle myself. Oh, here comes Bobby Lee. Yeah.
God. Says nobody ever. Here comes a 6'7" Bobby Lee.
Yeah, bro. Yeah, dude. Unbelievable.
Bobby
man.
Tree over here. Ain't nobody buying that, dog. That's a lazy costume, Chin. That is a lazy costume, dog.
What are you talking about?
Nope.
You look like a librarian at a fucking motorcycle outlet.
I can't believe Snickers went all the way to three.
Me either. Ugh.
Yeah, first of all,
Yeah, Chin, bad outfit, bad pick.
No, I think it's a great pick. I would have number one overall coming
really?
In.
Really? It's like picking Greg Jennings right now.
This is tough for me because these are my favorite candy. I love milk, dog.
Pick one. Yeah. You're that lame kid who gets back and he's like, well, okay, let me count them all out. One Jolly Rancher.
Do you guys like to trade candy?
Huh?
At the end, yeah. Then
I'm saying once when you got all your bags, you shuffle them all out. You trade. Mm-hmm.
Start wheeling and dealing.
Yeah, dude, I would have. Good and plenty.
And then we used to get the suppositories too, dude.
Oh.
Chappelle, you're up.
Oh, yeah.
Damn, there's a hammer.
I can't even see.
Dude, I used to get up.
Yeah, I think I'm good.
Okay.
Dang.
Damn, dude.
Hell, man.
These costumes scary, huh?
Yeah.
Where'd you find a hammer?
It was on the ground.
I don't have a hammer.
I think it's from Chappelle's outfit.
Wario, is that yours?
No.
That's Chappelle's?
Wario don't have no hammer.
Since it's Halloween, you need a Luigi board.
Ooh. Yeah, what? That's a great idea.
I'm always
trying to
do some freaky shit.
Some freaky.
Well, you're up, Nick.
A lot of
and voodoo. I get the wraparound, so I get two picks in a row.
Okay.
All right.
Fine. The wraparound. Another podcast network guy.
Damn, get your dick out of our face, Nick. Oh, man. Hey, would a few squats kill you every now and then? You feel me? You need to get with Theo's trainer, though.
Bro, look at that.
You got that Mr. Burns ass.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
He's got that math doing ass. Yeah. Somebody got that math doing ass, bro.
Look like you take a shit laying down, Nick.
Like two sheets of loose leaf paper back there.
Oh, shit, guys.
Oh, Nick got two sheets of loose leaf paper back there, bro.
You better call Theo's trainer ASAP, son.
ASSAP, bro. You want half a cheek, dog? Oh, you got those suckers?
I love those caramel apple suckers.
You can get those at the bank, dude.
Yeah. The analytics team said it was a great pick.
God, Nick's dick's all over. Nick got a dick on him, y'all. That green suit proves it, man.
What are you talking about?
I do all right.
Why are you looking at somebody's dick? That's not your own dick.
How can you avoid it, man? He's in a fucking green spandex.
Bro,
he comes over and puts the candy in my face, dog.
You with that horse's wiener? You about look talking about Nick's wiener?
Dude, you don't want a new podcast network and not have a dick on you.
That's okay. He got that mantenna, bro. That's the thing I worry about with Chappelle, dude. What? Chappelle's so white, bro, you worry about the size of his penis, you know?
Dude, I've thought about it a lot. I'm glad you said that.
Bro, you listening to my Slipknot.
Penis just starts to shrink.
You're up, Brendan.
Damn, Chappelle just picks the obvious candy, Doug.
Wait, what do you mean? What?
M&M's and Reese's? I mean...
Obviously, you sold those to support some basketball team growing up.
Those are the most... Bro, that's hilarious.
Come on, dude. Oh, my. Hey, mister.
Hey, man. We're trying to get New Jerseys, man.
You better try to get New Jerseys.
Hey, mister.
It's only $1.
We're trying to go on the road. You
Hey, mister, me and my friends are saving up to go on the Beck cruise. Can you help us raise some money, sir?
Yeah, Brandon.
You like Beck, Chappelle?
Huh? I like Beck?
He will.
Yeah, Beck's great.
I sat across, I almost lied, from Beck on an airplane once.
Oh, okay.
Did you say anything?
I did get a phone number of someone who worked in his band, a woman.
Oh.
And I never called her, though.
Oh.
But I should have.
You should have.
But she, yeah, it's over now.
How long ago was that?
This was probably, I'm not sure how long ago. It was at some point.
Mm-hmm. You guys know the tape does work, right?
Yeah, it seems pretty strong, but just in case.
Yeah, it's, yeah.
Oh, what's that, Jen? Gummy worms?
Gummy worms. I got all the good ones.
Cat looking fly in that pic, huh?
No.
Thanks.
Yeah, I took that off her Instagram. I took out the rest
of it. Oh, you took the milk duds.
Oh, you cut the breast out. I see that.
Yep, you got it.
Why'd you get rid of the sweater puppies?
That's for Patreon. You put the sweater puppies back on for the Patreon.
Yeah. Ooh. Ooh. Brennan's on Gatreon.
That's good.
As a chief yet. Well. What do we want to do here?
Oh. What is that?
Nerds.
Just that little pack of nerds, dog. The original classic.
The classic.
Yeah, don't let the sizes throw you off either. If it's a baby one, we're just saying the type of candy. Like, just because it's a baby Mounds, don't be like, oh, I'm going to take the baby Mounds over the full-size Snickers.
We're seeing who has the best lineup. Does
Snickers ooh, I just
Theo, you got the wraparound. You got one more pick.
Oh, yeah.
The reach around, dog. That's all you, Tranny Andy.
Honestly, I like Chin's lineup so far the best. You got Snickers and gummy worms. It's a nice variety of chocolate.
Yep.
Gummy.
Chocolate's not too big. The gummies are
wait, what's
a bunch.
Wrong with mine? Mine's dope.
Ooh, I love Butterfinger.
Like you said, it's a little classic, a little
Butterfinger's
boring.
Butterfinger's so good.
I think I like Cat's lineup.
And you went peanut butter on both treats.
What? That's not
or peanut.
Peanut, butter.
Peanut.
Oh, peanut.
Y'all slacking, man.
Well, I'm not a big sour.
Y'all a couple slack at that.
I panicked, man. Honestly. You guys were talking about my ass. I didn't.
It's just freaking out.
I wanted to get out of the room.
Oh, like two pages in a book. Right there, dog. Pages in a book. You got that.
Looking like that kid's novel back there. Yeah. Not very thick. Damn, that is the weakest costume, dog.
It's almost.
It's all. You know what?
It's disappointing.
It's offensive. It's a fucking offensive.
It's offensive that you would. You gotta be by. Yeah, you need a stain on your shirt. You need urine on you somewhere.
He usually wears like an Iggy Pop shirt or something.
Yeah, you
like
need
that.
A couple of body fluids on you.
A vintage worn out shirt that's stretched out a little too much.
Yeah, you need a beautiful girlfriend that's gonna probably end up with me if something ever happens to him.
Brendan, you're up.
You have no. I just expected more out of you, Chin, honestly.
I'm sorry.
But it just didn't you expect more out of him, Kat?
Considering I didn't know what he even dressed up, yes. I told him we should have been Jackie Chan and I should have been Soo Young. And
oh, then, no. You should have done Rush Hour.
We
you go blackface mm-hmm. and you go.
Chappelle could sign off on it.
Oh, no. You got. Chappelle,
no, we were.
Should have done it.
We were going to do it. But
what happened?
We didn't have enough outfits.
You have no outfits.
I would do white. I would do. Can a black person do whiteface if they want?
Yeah.
Nick Cannon and Snoop Dogg did. I don't know if it's okay or
it's
not,
still
but they did it.
Jimmy Kimmel did it.
White chicks.
Oh yeah, white chicks.
Yeah, white chicks.
Oh yeah.
That's a great movie.
Here comes Mr. Irrelevant.
Look at that ass.
Brendan can't stop looking at
that
ass.
Damn, bro.
You and Chin should have an ass off.
Yeah, dude. And both of them already are.
We both
you guys
lose.
Both need to hit up fucking
lose.
Theo's trainer, man.
That ass is absent, dude.
All right, so who won?
Skittles.
I don't know how you decide.
Yeah, how do you?
Oh, damn, sure.
We'll put it out to the people.
Chappelle's looking pretty tasty, though.
That's what I'm talking about.
I love Mike and Ike.
Chappelle's does look good.
Mike and Ike's
Theo's definitely the worst.
No, Nick's is L Nation.
Is it?
Yeah.
Nick's is
totally.
He has
Brendan
Skittles.
Is very uncomfortable.
Mine's you gotta have a specific palate for mine. You feel me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, you have candy corn.
And they're
That got voted worst candy in the world.
They're good.
No, the one you posted on your Instagram. That candy is horrible.
What is it?
He posted something.
Oh yeah, that
on his,
one.
On his
it's
story.
Like a, I don't remember what kind.
It's it doesn't even have like a name on it. It's just like wrapped up.
The black or gray is black or orange.
Yeah,
it's black.
What is it?
Go to Theo's story.
Oh, I love like a Laffy Taffy, saltwater taffy. What are we talking?
You'll
about?
See. You'll know exactly what we're talking about.
Yeah, calm down, freaking taffy man. like a beach taffy, like a cinnamon taffy, like a
that.
Yeah.
Oh, those.
Oh,
suck.
God.
That candy.
And sometimes you got the freaking one on the bottom right that was like.
The nougat? You talking about that nougat?
Bro, watch your words
that was
in here,
dude. Yeah, Brendan, you got to chill, dude.
No, it's a nougat,
dude, bro.
No,
it's
you,
nougat.
You.
Quit saying it, dude.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, thank you for having my back, Theo.
Anytime, bro.
Great
this
boss.
Shit fucking pisses
great
me
boss.
Off.
Great boss.
This shit
anyways.
Pisses me off. But yeah, those candies are disgusting.
Yeah.
What do these little TikTokers want?
What's up, Theo and Brandon? Got a king or stinger for you guys. Me and my girlfriend trying to decide on a couple's costume idea for Halloween coming up. So if you guys can help us out, that'd be awesome, man. Gang, gang, buzz, buzz.
Okay.
Aww, okay. Beautiful little mixed couple right there.
Hell yeah. Mm-hmm. Keep licking them lips, Poppy.
Beautiful couple right there.
Beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah.
I'm thinking of a good. Well, let's. What do you guys think, Culture Corner? What do y'all think for a good couple's costume?
You could do like Ike and Tina Turner.
God, that's gay.
That's, I mean, that might be a bit aggressive.
It's, but also, hey, old. They're young, dude.
They're young, so they could be Meg Thee Stallion and Tori Lanez.
That's what I was thinking.
That's the modern day one.
She lives around.
Yep.
Yeah.
Nope, that's another old rap French. About.
Chris Brown and Rihanna?
Chris Brown and Rihanna?
That was 10 years ago.
But they know it.
But they know it, man. Yeah, they could be...
Those are too obvious. They could be, what about Cardi B and her man?
Offset?
Yeah.
Cardi B,
yeah.
Offset?
My girlfriend and I are going to be Earthquake and Typhoon 90s wrestlers.
Oh, is your girl is your girl a bigger woman?
No.
No, you've met her. She's been here before.
Oh, good. That's right. Well, maybe she put on some LBs.
Well, yeah, well, no.
They were good.
She's beautiful as ever.
She's a beautiful lady. What are you? Which one are you going to be, Nick, and does it even matter?
I think she called Earthquake, so I'm going to be Typhoon.
They like both that. Look like Earthquake.
That's awesome.
That's going to be dope. What are you guys doing? Just hanging around the house? Or
I don't know what the plan is. Just Royal Rumble.
I just there you go. Beat up the neighbors, huh?
Yeah. Royal Rumble in your pants, you feel me?
Yeah, dude, if you still like fucking somebody that you're seeing.
That's aggressive, dude. Sure, yeah.
It's just old-fashioned, man. Yeah.
That's what they do on holidays, though, bro.
Dude, if I'm seeing
somebody...
Meanwhile,
you're going to be dressed as Tranny Andy jacking off.
Yeah, maybe I'll dress up like Chin, huh?
You can do Bobby that.
Chin came in normal outfit saying,
Bobby
I'm Bobby Lee.
That ain't Bobby Lee.
You ain't
Lee,
not Bobby
dog.
Lee.
I love how you're just lying to us so straight-faced about it, dog. That ain't Bobby.
He put no
he
effort
just,
into
just
it,
forgot. He forgot it was Halloween.
No, dude.
Look at all the effort Chappelle went through.
Oh, no. You see what I'm a mop.
Yeah.
They called me a custodian the
finally,
whole damn time.
Bro. Finally.
My bad.
You're trying to be a metal singer, and they're just like, yo, you're a custodian.
Bro, you're a bustodian, though,
a bustodian.
Dude. Yeah, dude. You bust, and then Brennan sneaks over into it. Yeah. Brennan looks like somebody that would ice skate on some frozen bust. Oh.
Ooh, it's Bruce Jenner.
These are, yeah, these are actually King and the Sting fan submission videos of some of their costumes. Some
that's dope.
Real fast rip my drip.
Looks like my friend Kenny Garcia's girlfriend, actually.
That's a great one, man.
Okay. Oh, yeah, I have to sit like this because I can't look at this.
Oh, there's Bobby Lee. That's a lot more Bobby Lee right there.
Yeah, way more.
Ooh, King of the Sting.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's cool. Oh, that's dope.
Aw.
A little monster.
Man, look at that. Legend, bro.
That is legendary. That's the best one.
Oh, damn.
Ooh.
Ooh, she got some thigh thighs.
Bro, what are you talking to mother?
Yeah, so? Moms count too, dog.
Damn, Wario. Lay off the shrooms, bro.
Ooh, little gang.
Gang.
Mm-hmm.
Gang. And the Sting. Oh, there you go.
Aaron Hernandez.
That's little trap queen.
Are they
some little
Nick?
Thought. Oh, yeah. Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
That's a great one. With a singlet.
These are really good.
Gang, bro.
This is Hulk Hogan with his sex tape.
He's got a sex tape?
He does.
Hulk Hogan?
Yeah, it's like security footage from his home somebody stole.
I had an entire bit on it.
Mm-hmm. I know he has sex tape.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a little guy.
Oh, there's the terrorist. That's
going
to scare people.
Lieutenant Dan.
Terrorist is dope costume, bro.
That's hilarious.
Look at that ISIS costume. That is fantastic.
That's classic, dude.
Ooh, Undertaker.
Oh,
and
oh, that guy was on our podcast last week. That's Frank Johns.
The mortician, right?
Yeah. Yeah, it's frowned upon.
What did he say?
Huh?
What'd you...
Everything.
Really?
Learned all about it. You can get buried 12 feet if you want.
Instead of six?
Mm-hmm.
What is the difference?
Should we see a nice little montage of him?
Yeah, let me see that dude.
Quick.
All right, I got to take this mask off to look because I cannot see.
There you go. It's Chappelle.
Dave, that's when I came in, he didn't have the mask. I went, oh, you're Dave Chappelle.
Oh.
Because he always rocks the onesie.
Oh,
it's a good costume,
keep
man.
Keep a little bit of blood, put it on the plants or anything like that? You ever know anybody did anything like that?
No.
Now, can you eat near the bodies or not?
It's frowned upon.
I bet he's eaten by the bodies, though, huh?
1,000 or something.
Damn, bro. You going to hell, bro. He's in 4,000 embalms.
Do a lot of people die holding their penis, I feel like?
No.
How fast can you get me in the ground if I die? You guys do any like 8-hour packages or anything?
Get you in the ground pretty quick, depending upon the cemetery.
Amen. And how deep can you get me? Can I go 12 feet or it's only 6?
You can go deeper.
Have they ever caught anybody in your industry doing something vile or stealing blood or copping femurs or something out of deceased or anything? And have you ever accidentally had the wrong body in a clothes casket?
No.
Lying. And now, is it hard for you personally? If you have trouble, is it tough to meet women or something like that if you're working in the death trade, you know?
I would not say that it's a chick magnet.
That was good.
What were you drinking there? Said liquid death?
It's like water. A fancy water.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's a fancy water company.
I thought you were back drinking again. I was going to say, I found a drinking partner.
Yeah? If I come out, man, I'll come over there and drink.
Not if you come out of the closet. Well, dude, look. I'm still waiting for that day.
Bro, if I come out of the closet, who would I spend time with out of this room? I'll put that up on the candy board. It would probably still be Kat.
Oh, thanks, Theo.
Ooh, that one's dope.
Oh, that's dope.
That's good. That's good.
That's Sam Tripoli on the right?
I was going to be the Rat King too, hence why the back room is so a mess. I can't find the costume.
Oh, I have it at home.
Oh, man.
See, I told you. He likes to keep it close to him.
Yep. He can bust out any time.
Sometimes if there's trouble outside in the yard, I'll put it on.
Oh, yeah, scare the kids.
Oh, bro, scare everybody. Oh, yeah.
He nailed it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, he did great.
That's great. Oh, there's Ooh. Kat.
Ooh. Kat Tina there, baby.
Yeah, huh? There's Brendan.
Oh, that's is that Simple Jack?
Sling Blade.
Oh, word.
Sling Blade.
It
could have
been Simple Jack, though.
Simple Jack,
fair.
Same vibe.
Oh,
that's a good one.
That's a great one.
Love Austin that.
Stone Cold, Rock.
Mm-hmm. Damn, it looks just
Mankind.
Like
Mankind.
Lots
I love
of
Mankind.
Ooh.
That's
There's
a great
Miley
piece.
Cyrus and her dad.
that's Beth and Rip Wheeler from Yellowstone.
Is it?
Yeah.
That's a deep pull.
If you're a Yellowstone fan, you know exactly what's going on.
I think that's Miley Cyrus, dude.
No, I'm telling you, that's Yellowstone, Doug.
That's Miley Cyrus and Matt West, I think, or Matt...
Matt West.
Matt West from...
PBR.
PBR.
Nope.
Oh.
Whatever.
And Megan, his lovely fiance Megan.
And Megan's lovely fiance.
that does it for our King of the
Damn,
thing.
Those were great.
Fancy missions. They were great. They were great.
So what did those kids ask us?
Costumes.
Oh, couple costumes.
We've got more videos. Those are just all the costumes.
What would y'all do? Chappelle, what do you think is a good couple costume for that pair?
For them, since they're so
Ooh,
young.
Ooh, go as Machine Gun Kelly and
Megan
Fox.
I said Chappelle.
I know, that just hit me, though.
Yeah.
Well, if I were them, I'd you know, probably Slipknot, you know, add another person to the mix, you know. Like, hey, sweetheart, let's be Slipknot.
Like, who are some other Slipknot characters they could be?
They could be Mick, you know. They could be, you know.
Are there
Joey
any females
Jordison.
In the group?
There's no females in Slipknot.
Not shocked.
Yeah, not shocked.
A lot. Not shocked.
Let me guess, their concert's real cock fest. Hey, is your girl dressing up?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's.
I
dude,
didn't ask.
Halloween's
her.
On Saturday.
Yeah, I think she. Yeah, she just realized it too.
Is she gonna dress in her regular clothes and say she's Bobby Lee?
Fuck, man. It's tight.
That shit is weak, Jim.
I like how he keeps trying
choking
to
my neck.
Shit is weak.
It's like, look at the hood. Look at the hood.
Unbelievable, Jim.
Let me see this video, Nick.
Debate Club. Aww. Store bought costumes or homemade? Say goodbye. Bye. Aww. Gang, gang, bud, buzz. Aww.
She said store bought costumes are homemade.
That's a good question. That's me also. I would say, homemade's the best, man.
Homemade by far. Listen, dude. If you buy it at the store, one time me and my brother went to a Halloween party in Denver. It's freezing out. My brother decided to buy a costume of a penguin. Mm-hmm. We showed up to the party. There were 17 other fucking penguins.
Yeah.
My brother got all drunk, fought the other penguins. Yeah, fuck these other penguins up, man.
Yeah, they do that.
It was a real penguin war. Yeah,
exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah, every winter they fight each other to see who can keep the eggs.
Yeah, Jay Schaub.
And the man will go away for months.
Jay Schaub fought these other penguins.
They steal eggs too, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Penguins assholes, man.
Yeah, they're just doing their best. They do go hard. That's a good point,
Jay
man.
Schaub got drunk and went hard in the paint in his costume.
Oh, did he steal somebody's egg?
He really went out and pushed another penguin over a couch.
Oh, damn. Okay, Jay Schaub.
But it's also very easy for a penguin to fall over a couch, I feel like.
Yeah.
You know, you have no.
Yeah, they waddle when they walk.
Yeah.
They ain't got no knees.
Point is, homemade's way better because then it's more original.
But homemade also is risque, man. I remember having to make my own homemade growing up. And so I was like, I remember doing a archer one time, like a Peter Pan archer. Mm-hmm. And
you mean Robin Hood?
Yeah, Robin Hood. Yeah. So I did so much like monofilament line trying to keep it all together, though. It looked like a bustier, you know, in the front and back.
So you had some tits?
Oh, I had tits in the front and tits in the low tits in the back, dude. Yeah, it's disgusting. I was a child. But, so sometimes, man, it's unbelievable, you know. And it was like a 200-pound test line, dude, so I couldn't get out of that shit, bro. My whole body started turning, my arms started turning blue from, like, blocking off the blood.
But that shit's dope. Nobody else had it. Like, my French robot, you ain't never seen that on the streets.
I mean, you haven't.
What's up?
That's the only picture I've seen.
Homemade all day, man.
Yeah. Agreed. And what else did? What were you when you were a kid, Chen? You don't remember? You said
I don't remember my Halloween.
What do you?
Come on,
what?
You know how many Warriors? You don't remember Saturday?
You know how many years you were alive when you were a kid, Chen?
Yeah. I know my Halloween costumes when I was an adult.
Okay.
Yeah.
You want to hear those?
Yeah.
Sure.
Huh? I dressed up
as Bobby Lee.
No. Again. You know when you go? There's like clubs you can go to for Halloween. You're adults.
It's called a party.
The party. So I would get those fake gold chains and silver chains and with pendants. Mm. Make fake tattoos.
Cultural appropriation.
Uh-huh. Fake tattoos, and I bought a big woman's fur coat. And then I would do magic tricks because I was reading that book, The Game. I was picking up girls doing magic tricks.
This guy dicey.
And it worked.
Did it?
Yes.
I'll tell you this story.
I got dicey.
I bought the coat at
Burlington. You put on a bunch of jewelry and a fur coat.
Yeah. Burlington Coat
Factory. Trick women with magic.
Thanks for taking us through that shitty John Grisham novel. Yeah. Jesus, bro.
Were you David Blaine?
We're going to buy that story at the airport. It's horrible. Here's what I'll tell you, dude, is one time I did Jesus Christ, bro. Jesus Christ.
Okay.
And my girlfriend was the devil, and I made a real cross out of wood and brought it to a party.
And we carried that.
Carried it the whole night.
You did?
Yeah, it was like a 45-pound cross, too.
What a terrible idea.
No homo, bro.
What a terrible idea, though. Were you exhausted?
Oh, but I did not give up, dude. I made her carry it once when I went to the bathroom.
Ooh, I bet that looked weird.
Yeah. Yeah, I bet that did look good. But
ooh,
then,
was she a spicy Satan, though?
Yeah.
Yeah,
was.
Some big horns out the front.
Yeah, tits.
Yeah. A tail out the back.
Some milk horns, yeah.
Yeah, dog.
And then what else, dude? One time, I was pedophile a lot when I was in college.
Makes sense.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Pedophile was great because here's what you could do. You could
hit on young girls?
No, you could. Oh, you just had to be real quiet, get a mustache. Mm-hmm. Like a shirt that has like some leather on the.
Like those patches?
Yep. Yeah. Put some markers in your pocket.
The glasses.
Get the glasses.
Yep.
Mustache. Stand over off in the distance. Get you a little beer, maybe a little coat.
Yep. Oh, you would need wine coolers.
Oh, yeah, but I don't know if I had any of that.
Mike's hard.
Oh, that too.
Oh, dude, Mike was hard. Pretty lame joke, really. I wouldn't have laughed at that. But
your delivery was great, though.
Thank you. I appreciate that, dude. Thank you, Mop. Okay, Jesus Christ. It's hard when you have the only support in here is coming from a mop, bro. But
I'll get you.
I'm particular, bro.
I'll get you. I'll get you.
I love
That's
it.
That's that new Broadway musical, that Mop. Right. Hey.
Oh, my God.
I'll get you. That dirty mop.
Yeah. I'll get you. I'll
it's
get
only
you.
A day
away. What else did I dress up as, man? I was pedophile a couple years. I was Where's Waldo one year before everybody else was Where's Waldo. I was Where's Waldo before anybody had done it.
Where's Waldo was super popular.
I was before that. My friend Todd drank some gasoline, and he had to go to the hospital.
Ooh, I bet he got lit.
He's never been the same. He wasn't the same before it, though.
Yeah.
He wasn't much before it, but what else did I do?
Me and my brother in college dressed up as two nerds, but now I look back on it, we look like two pedophiles because that outfit you just described is exactly how we dress. Yeah.
Oh, man.
That nerd nation. Oh, one time I was on this cruise ship, and they had we were limited costumes, and people were, you know, this one fellow sold his pubic hair to be used as mustache.
Oh, ooh. Yeah, it's dicey.
And I bought a little, not much. Yeah,
not a lot.
I wasn't going heavy, dog.
Dog, in college, me and my roommates dressed up as,
you know,
we didn't have any costume ideas. So
I'm not wearing a lot of another man's pubic hair around my fucking mouth, dude. Like some freak.
Only a little, huh?
Just something young, yeah. That 13-year-old mustache. Dog, you know?
In college, nobody had any outfits, and we were throwing the Halloween party at our house in college. So I went, don't worry, I got this. So I went to fucking Ralph's and got Depends, the big diapers. Mm-hmm. And I was like, well, I'll be big babies. So we all put these diapers on and had nothing else on. We got real wasted. And then these hot chicks walked in. I heard them go, ugh, this is disgusting.
Damn.
And it hurt our feelings. Yeah.
You got your feelings hurt?
Yeah, hell yeah.
Well,
yeah.
That's what you deserve,
mom,
dude.
I'll cheer you the fuck up. You
yeah,
know?
Dude.
Yeah, you're the cool mom.
If you would have had me there, I would have cheered you up on
hell
that.
Hell yeah.
He'll shine your floors,
clean
man.
Clean up on aisle 7.
Yeah. Oh, champ. Hey.
Hell yeah, dude.
I'm going to get you.
I'm going to get you. I'll clean it up. I'll clean it up.
He does look like a mom. Nah, I'll leave it. I got this.
You guys are good. I'll clean it up.
Here's Frank Castillo has a question right here, man.
Shout out to Frank.
Great and he barred my nose to ask it.
What's up, Brandon? What's up, Theo? Fourth corner, Nick Chin. This is Daniel coming at you from the beautiful island of Guam.
Ooh.
I'm out here serving my country. But I got a quick king and a stinger for you guys.
Like that shirt.
Talking yeah, about those horror tattoos.
His are sick.
That's dope.
We got that Jason.
Damn, that's good work.
That's so scary. Good.
Now, you're only cool in October, but that's all right.
One of my favorite ones is Pennywise.
Wow. Oh, my God. That's dope.
Guys sting. King of Sting It. Gang, gang, buzz, buzz.
Dude, King It, especially in October, you're a real hit. The rest of the holidays get a little dicey. And then Sting It if you have kids. That probably scares the shit out of kids.
Really?
Could be don't scary. Get immune to it.
Ugh.
I feel like you would get used to it when you grow up seeing it all the time.
I don't know. That It tattoo scares me at 37 years old.
That could be scary for a child, man.
Yeah.
You can't hug a child with that kind of arm.
That
bro.
Shit is.
But maybe in Guam, they different.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They're not little pussies. That It tattoo is so good. Mm-hmm. That artwork is insane.
Yeah. In Guam, they're probably different, man. Look up something scary in Guam.
Anybody ever
been like a hurricane?
Chupacabra?
Maybe
no,
a
that's
hurricane.
Mexico.
I'm saying, do they have something like that in Guam?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'm sure.
Anybody ever been to Guam here?
Mm-mm. I might have been there.
Might have been
there. I don't know where I've been these days.
Something scary from Guam.
Haunts. Some like tall tale they got, you know?
Oh, they got haunted houses. Dude, are haunted houses still popping during COVID, or can we not do that?
They have like drive-through ones where it's like a haunted drive. Yeah.
I'm out.
You in Arizona, they're doing them back home.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, damn. We're there next week.
I'm not going to a haunted house.
What really? Else they say?
You look like you just got off.
He's like, I don't want to go back to work.
In Guam, you can go back in time. So if you did something you could regret, go back in time and fix it.
By the way, what they do for people in Guam?
You can do it a little. You can go back about 40 minutes. I said local residents.
Dude, maybe we should do a podcast trip there. Go to Guam, dog.
Hey, so I do remember now. It came back to me.
Uh-oh, there you go.
When fake. I was a kid. Let's no, hear. I'm serious.
Yeah, that's a fake story.
No. You remember Greatest American Hero?
Nope.
He had a red suit on and he had an afro, but it was a white guy. He flew, but
was he
could
one of
never
the American
land.
Gladiators?
No. He could never land, though. He would fall and start tumbling?
No.
No.
So my mom would perm my hair, and what she made my outfit.
Oh, you're older than us. You have a,
what does he look like?
Greatest American Hero.
Oh, never.
You it's, know, not, it's not Hulk
believe
Hogan?
It or not, I'm walking on air. Da, 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 da. That was the theme song. That's what I just, that's what I was when I was a kid.
Just got sad.
You guys don't remember this.
That was your outfit, okay? Though?
Yes.
Oh, he looks
that man
so...
gay.
Thank you.
That man so gay is... I mean, come on now.
Like Richard Simmons.
So he was a superhero, but he couldn't like land. Though.
Richard Simmons looked like The Rock. That
boy
chick
is fine though.
Yeah, the girl is really hot.
That's the OG Captain America.
The greatest OG. American hero.
Yes. There you go.
He looks like
have you ever seen the movie Sinister? That's the sign that Sinister leaves on all the
what?
It is?
Yeah.
Never scary. Seen that
movie. Yeah,
with Ethan Hawke, right?
Scary. Yeah.
That's scary.
You know that got voted scariest movie.
Yep.
What did?
Sinister. Over the Exorcist?
Yeah, oh yeah.
No way.
Have you seen Sinister?
Sinister's not that scary, I don't
Ooh,
think.
I was scared. Part 2's good too.
Really? I've never seen it.
I can't.
You've never seen it?
Nope.
You just said it's not scary.
I know.
Oh, it's similar.
Sinister's a great movie.
I was guessing.
I like the new It's too. I was watching It last night. Uh-uh. The girl fell asleep. I was scared.
Yeah.
The worst movie was the new Michael Myers, the latest one, the Halloween from last year.
That's what you get.
Is that what Jamie Lee Curtis?
That's what you get for watching it, dude.
So bad.
Terrible.
So bad. You didn't it like wasn't
the,
even scary.
Have you seen the new It's though? Mm-mm. Oh, they're good. God damn, they're good.
I don't know.
The old
man.
It's good too. Still holds up over time.
Damn.
Bad acting, but whatever.
I don't know, man. I got to freaking do 4 years in the Persian Gulf coming up. I'm in the Navy.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm. I respect it.
Thanks, man. Appreciate my service.
Yeah.
Appreciate my service.
I appreciate
What's
it.
This, Nick?
Ooh.
This looks like another Ooh, promotion for Nick's boy. New podcast network.
Is that Jess Lockwood right there?
That's actually kind of cool.
That's awesome. I love Pitbulls. She's got a video to go along with it.
Yeah, I love Pitbulls. Running on in
and she's a him.
Brandon and Theo, what's going on?
What's up, brother?
Coming to you from Toronto, Ontario, Canada.
Yes, I love Toronto.
And with Halloween around the corner, I got a king it or sting it for you. Dog Halloween costumes.
Oh, that thing's bucking like he's a horse.
Gang, gang, buzz, buzz.
Buzz, I love buzz. It, man. I think if you got a dog, you dress him up. And that's what he gets.
Yep.
That's what he gets for living at somebody else's house, eating out of a small bowl all
Not
the time.
Paying rent.
Yeah.
Freeloader.
Dress his little ass up. I put him in a little thong, too.
Hell yeah. A little thong out the back.
Put a little thong on that asshole.
Nuts out the side. Hell yeah.
Amen. Welcome to West Hollywood, dude. Welcome to Hollywood, period.
Hell yeah. Welcome to the Abbey, little bitch.
Yeah, dog.
Hell yeah.
Or also, you could get him, dress him in something real Mexican, you know? Some fool's gone wild shit.
Ooh.
A lot of dogs, or perros, they call them.
Perro.
Can be, can dress up like fool's gone wild.
Fool's gone wild.
You could also dress your character. Dog, you could dress your dog as dog face. Put on a skateboard.
Yeah. Put a little feather on the
side. Yeah, put a little cranberry.
A lot of people are going to be dog face. I bet dog face is one of the number one costumes this year.
Oh, yeah, it has to be.
Oh, you just carry around cranberry juice?
Yeah.
On a skateboard?
Yeah.
Because it's nice if you have something to drink, you know? Mm-hmm. Get you a little Mexican drink or something.
And something good happened to Dogface too. He got some new thing. I think he just bought a house.
Mm-hmm. Somebody gave him a house. Ocean Spray gave him a damn house.
They gave him a damn house?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's balling.
Shout out to Ocean Spray.
They built him a little water, a house made out of, it looks like an Ocean Spray bottle.
Yeah.
The only way to get in and out of the house is through the top. You have to twist the door open. But no, he's living it up. Every day he's got something new going on.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's crushing it.
So
he's big vibes, man.
He's just coasting, bro.
Yeah.
He's enjoying it, man. He's doing what we should all be doing.
Yeah.
Loving life.
Loving life.
Amen, man.
Amen.
Happy Halloween, huh?
Happy Halloween, everybody. Be safe out there, kids.
Yeah,
last year we were Buzz Lightyear and Woody.
Mm-hmm.
You know, budget cuts.
Pandemic, man. It's pandemic.
Yeah, it's tough times.
Tough times, Holmes.
It's tough times, Holmes.
I would say best costume of the day goes to the mop over there.
Hey, thank
I would
you
agree.
Guys. I appreciate that.
The happy mop off Broadway.
Yeah, I'm going to get you. That's the name of my. That's the name of the play. Yeah, I'm going to get you.
New single. I'm going to get you.
Dang, it's scary, though. He's scary.
Yeah, you are scary. But now that we keep calling you a mop, you look friendly.
It's getting better.
Yeah, it's getting better. I'm growing on y'all.
Now, what about Cat though?
Cat, yeah.
Cats is the most creative.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Chin's was the weakest. Let's be real. Let's call it what it is. Oh. Also, Nick, you could have put a little more effort in. You got your dick in our face. You got your flat ass.
That's
out
a
the
lot
back.
Of effort, dog. Yeah.
I came here today expecting to be the Rat King. I was practicing my lines.
Nick. Yeah. Nick, you were very brave today.
Would have been nice. They had a couple Rat Kings last year. We saw a couple.
Nick, you should have dressed up as Iggy Azalea.
Oh my God.
Iggy,
yeah.
Iggy, pussy, pussy.
Iggy, Iggy, pussy, pussy, pop it, pop it. Remember that?
Yeah.
Yeah, he remembers it.
How can he forget?
She's a single mom now.
Very hard to forget.
She's
is she
single
really?
Single mom?
I saw that coming.
Oh, damn.
Who isn't? Who isn't a single mom? When are you going to have one, Kat?
I don't know. I would like to have one end of my 20s, early 30s. So in the
years?
Like, no, okay. I'm 25 now. So like, if there's anybody who wants to have a kid in 3 years, let
be
me
careful
know.
Careful now, Kat. You're a lot of donors.
Yeah.
I just want to keep my options open right now. You know,
they're open.
Flip through a book.
Yep, they're open.
Why don't you have one, Theo?
Yeah, I'm thinking about having one.
47 years old.
Dude, F you, bro. You look like a freaking valet at somebody's colon.
Right? Touched a nerve.
My bad. Yeah. Sorry, dude.
But fuck you, bro. Damn, Raggedy Ann. I didn't know that was the one that would get you. All the years of jokes. That's the one that got you. I said have a kid and fucking... fuck you, bro. I'm fucking trying, man.
Dude, I masturbated yesterday, you fool.
Yeah, you're in
well, that ain't helping anybody.
Yeah, dog.
It's training them.
I'm going to move to East LA and have a Fool's Gone Wild baby, dog.
Ooh, do that. Get with just a real freaking...
They get verified yet?
Oh, dude. They haven't been verified
they
yet.
They need to.
Breaks verify my them, heart, please.
Nick, when are you going to have a kid?
I don't know. After getting married, I'm not going to have one.
Out of wedlock.
Yeah. Ideally. Yeah.
Are you 28?
32.
Same thing.
are you thinking about marriage?
For sure, one day.
Wow.
Yeah.
Hell what? Yeah, dude.
It hasn't even been a year with my girlfriend, but...
sorry.
Shit, love is tight, though.
I told her I love her, love is tight.
Whoa, you guys are...
It's the Halloween episode, you fucks.
Hey, I'm just saying.
Hey, easy.
Hey,
you guys love your girlfriends? Y'all are gay.
Yeah, this ain't love.
I love her.
Gay.
I love my girlfriend.
You asked me about a kid, and first comes love.
Yeah,
then
I know, but
marriage.
But Chevelle's going too hard in the love. In the dude, you can't dress like that and tell us about
bro,
love is tight.
Bro.
Chin, you and your girl?
We don't want kids.
Never?
Oh, yeah. My God,
boy,
Chin.
That always
how many
sad.
L's? How many L's you want to take?
Yeah, right, dog. Came in with a costume. Hard L.
We don't
hard
want L. kids. I'm Bobby Lee. We don't want kids. I'm having a great time. Oh, look. Oh.
Chappelle, you
I
want
shouldn't
kids?
Say that. I love
yeah,
you.
I think, yeah.
Chappelle needs to have some kids, dude.
Yeah, he'd be a good dad.
I want to see one of some of those angry
you,
kids
in
he
the,
has.
Worked in the daycare.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Chappelle's worked everywhere, dude.
Yeah.
Everything you say to Chappelle's done it.
Uh-huh.
High school, daycare. He was a governor, he said somewhere.
Yeah, I was a governor at one
college.
Point.
Yeah.
College.
Yeah, college, NASA, he told me the other day.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Oh, yeah, we were talking about it. Yeah. I told Theo, I was like, yeah, I worked for NASA. He's like, whoa.
He said he had a space shuttle with a V6 in it.
Uh-huh.
I was like, I don't know, man.
Thing was great.
Yeah.
Well, happy Halloween,
happy
y'all.
Halloween, happy Halloween, y'all.
I'm in Phoenix next week. Stand up live Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Phoenix. And I'm in Nashville, dog.
Yeah, that's right.
And I'm in Nashville, Zanies. And then Boise, Idaho. One show, theater show, December 5th.
I love
Boise, Idaho. Almost sold out. About to add a second show, you little old maggots.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm trying to get some shows, man. I don't have anything on the docket right now, but...
You're getting up in Nashville, though.
I thought about maybe getting up November 4th. Do you think it's weird to get up the day after the election or not?
Yeah, no, I'll do it.
Nah, people
perfect
need
timing.
To get out.
They need it.
You think?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe November 4th I'll get out.
There you go.
So maybe keep your eyes out for that.
Maybe you come by Zany's Nashville.
Yeah.
I might.
Yep, we'll see.
Let's see what I'm doing. A man might be busy.
Oh, I'll be at Tempe
Improv. Oh, let me look at your schedule.
Oh, okay, Brendan, thanks.
Wide open.
Look at it. I'm just going to come y'all.
Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, are you going to be a Zany Stew? Are you coming?
No.
Yeah, he'll be a Zany.
Yeah, yeah. I'll be a Zany.
Oh, damn, okay.
But November 27th through the 29th, I'll be at Tempe Improv, my hometown. Come say what's up.
Gang.
Those tickets are online.
You going to dress like that?
No, I won't.
You should?
Yeah, I'll be regular me. I'll go back to me.
Happy Halloween, y'all.
Happy Halloween, y'all.
Happy Halloween, guys.
Japan is starting to look like he gave up. If you're struggling, I can spot you for the Dollar Shave Club. Keanu Reeves wants his beard back, enough is enough.